My name is Mikki Mase. I am one of the biggest gamblers in Las Vegas history. By age 29, I was one of Las Vegas's biggest winners of all time, and I was up tens of millions of dollars. I was winning so much that the whole city was out to get me. I was born in Jersey. I come from like a really long line of high stakes gamblers. Family time kind of consisted of going to the New York City card room and just sort of hanging out. My grandparents would go to Atlantic City every week. They would take me and sometimes my younger brother, and we'd always get thrown out from the casinos for being underage. And my grandparents got really tired of cutting their trip short. So they went and bought fake identities for my brother and I so we can pass in the casinos. I moved to Los Angeles. And when I moved to Los Angeles, Vegas is only a 45-minute flight away. So I couldn't help it. I would go to Vegas once a week and just party. While I was partying, I'd gamble some, and I started winning and winning a lot. I was about to party so hard that I was gonna bring Vegas to its knees. I was exclusively a blackjack player, and I liked to play the largest stakes I could, but they would never let me bet enough. And one of my buddies played blackjack and baccarat, and I was unfamiliar with baccarat. And he said to me, he goes, just so you know, you can always bet twice the bet sizing in baccarat that you're permitted to in blackjack. It's standard policy in all casinos in the world. That's all he needed to tell me is that I can bet more. Baccarat is a card game. Before the cards come out, you make a bet. The main bet is either player or banker. After the cards are dealt, there'll be two for player, two for banker. When you add them together, closest to nine wins. It also is the best odds in any casino. The odds are 50-50. The odds are so good that on half of your bets, you owe a 5% commission back to the house. The only way to win big is to bet big. And when I gamble, I wanna play as big as I can, as fast as I can, as hard as I can. I wanna bet the biggest limits they'll let me. The number one advice I have for anybody who wants to gamble successfully is they need to have somebody sit with them that's not gambling. And this person needs to know you really well so they can keep an eye on you. When you're losing, they need to help you walk away from the table and they have to hold you accountable so you don't lose while you're in the wrong state of mind. And the same goes for when you're winning. Baccarat is a game of luck. I have formulated an algorithm that helps to not just decrease the variance in it, but more specifically decrease the house edge and increase the player's edge. I have found a way to beat Baccarat. Casinos don't like that. They don't understand exactly what my algorithm is, and they're having a lot of trouble stopping it, which is how I've won the tens of millions.
What is this algorithm you use?
I don't think I can answer that question because part of that answer I'm selling for $50 million.
Okay, well, I definitely don't want to impoverish you for $50 million.
Me against the casinos is absolutely a war. As a matter of fact, everybody's in this war, whether they realize it or not. Las Vegas wasn't built on winners, and they've become the top professionals in the world at making sure you lose. There are countries around the world that hired Las Vegas casino security to run their national security. So that's how far advanced the security systems and companies that run these Las Vegas casinos are. And they had tried everything to stop me from winning. A lot of the casinos had felt early on that I was a liability. The casino set me up where I can lose not just my money, but I can lose my life. Casinos would do anything to like throw me off my game. They took away the jet, they took away the cars, they took away the butlers. They would not give me rooms anymore. They would manipulate my room service. They would block my cell signal. They've done things as arbitrary and silly as that, all the way to set me up to get robbed for money. I was in Vegas with my buddy Ian. I had a goal that day, and my goal was to win as much as I can, as fast as I can. The problem is the casinos are so smart, way smarter than I'll ever be. Casinos build edges against all their players, and they never speak about it publicly. They don't market it, they don't discuss it, and they'll shut down any conversation about it. So I knew to get in and out as fast as I could. So in the shortest amount of time, how can I bet the most amount of money? We bought in for $500,000 that morning. And as soon as we hit a million, as fast as possible, we cashed out, we took the cash, we took the money and went to the next casino. And I took the million to 2 million.
There it is, baby!
I took that 2 million up to about 3 million. And then I took that 3 million in cash as fast as I could, went over to the next casino. And I remember screaming at the cashier, count it faster, get more staff, get more staff. By the time they counted the 3 million, it was at the time, I had already won another 1.5 million and I had 4.5 million. And I just took it back to the cage and I said, cash me out again. Between four casinos, it took us 3 hours. We started with 500K and we left with 4.5 million in cash. All casinos, whether the public knows it or not, they have secret cages that are highly secure. They're private rooms for large transactions. These rooms are also protected by security. 4.5 million weighs a lot. It weighed too much for me to just to like carry, and they didn't have any bags. So what we ended up doing was, I had security take the 4.5 million, put it on the bell cart, and push it through the casino to the main valet where Ian had ran, grabbed this beamer, and pulled it to the doors. Security is loading the 4.5 million in cash. It's not hidden, it's not in bags, it's just cash in clear cellophane, like vac seal wrap, but it's 500,000 in $100 bills. So they load the 4.5 million in the back seat. Me and Ian get in, and I look in the rear view, and I see headlights of an SUV turn on. Where this SUV was sitting was not actually an entrance or an exit. It was tucked away in this little cove at the main valet, and no valet driver would let a civilian park their own vehicle there. I was being set up. When I first saw those headlights turn on, I immediately went to worst case scenario. They knew exactly how much cash was in that car. They knew who was in that car. There was really no getting away from what was about to happen. They were coming for my money and possibly my life. We go to pull out, and we pull onto Las Vegas Boulevard, and so does the truck. And I said, Ian, make a U-turn. Right now, we're gonna figure out, are we being chased? I was at like 80% that this wasn't gonna end well.
Make a U-turn.
We go to make a U-turn. Now we're driving up the strip on the other side, and the truck also made a U-turn. I said, we're being followed. Ian smashes the pedal, and we take off. The truck took off also. Now we're in a high-speed pursuit up Las Vegas Boulevard. The jig is up, like there's no hiding, there's no like slyness of this SUV. They're doing anything they can to keep up with us. And I'm thinking like, I don't think we're gonna get away. Like, I don't think we have an option here. I was in full-blown panic. I mean, my heart, outside of my own control, was beating through my chest. And I just kept thinking to myself, I have to keep my wits about me or there will be no possibility of solution. My heart was going crazy. We might get killed, we're gonna get robbed. You know, people do a lot of crazy things for a lot less than 4.5 million in unmarked cash.
This is not happening, this is not happening. Go, where am I supposed to go?
We were driving, and Ian said that he remembered a hotel that does trunk checks.
There's a trunk checkpoint.
A trunk check is when you pull up and security wants to check inside of the trunk to make sure you don't have any weapons or any other dangerous materials. It was genius. So we pulled into that casino's entrance and the security came up and said, please pop your trunk. And I said,
please don't be suspicious. Look in the back seat.
And he looks and he sees 4.5 million in cash. And I was like, I don't know the right tone to talk right now. I don't know the right words to say. I don't know the right level of urgency to express. I kept my body really calm, but I used my words with urgency. And I said, you see the SUV back there? He goes, yeah. I said, we're being followed. They're trying to rob us. I said, okay, I got you guys.
I'm gonna hold them up, all right?
He said, you're gonna stick right. You're gonna get into the employee parking lot. You're gonna make the following turns. When you get to the exit, make a right and just get out of town. It hit me and I was like, is this a good plan? And I didn't have enough time to think it out. Now I'm worried about Ian, who's actually in the driver's seat. Ian is behind the wheel of my destiny. And I was really scared that he was gonna start panicking, make the wrong decisions, and it was gonna be full-blown chaos. And I said to myself, I can't even think about if this will work. It is our only option. So the second that me and Ian pulled out through the security check, he guns it and he's booking it. Like, we're not even discreet. Now I'm like looking around. I'm like making sure the truck's not following us. And me and Ian are like, what did he say? He said, go right, go left. And we're like screaming at each other. Left, 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 right, 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 go straight, go straight. We're like, here it is, here it is.
Dude, there's it.
And we get out of there. And as soon as we hit call vault, that's when we started celebrating.
Yes!
And we just left and never stopped till we hit LA. We just have 4.5 million sitting in the back seat. It's just us two morons just driving around, you know. And for us, we're still like sweating, our hearts are racing. We like can't believe what just took place.
Unreal.
I have never ran for my life in the passenger seat of a car with 4.5 million, you know, like being set up by the casino staff. I've never had that before. And to get away from that was like the biggest F you to the casinos I could have had. Yeah, it was cool. That was sweet.